Hi, I'm Chris from Web Motor Works. I'm here with my daughter, Emily. Now, a couple months ago, she came up with an idea. Dad, I want an electric hot rod. And of course, I'm a motor guy on flatheads and big motors. I got 8 carburetors on my other. And it's like, electric motors? Are you kidding? That's for sissies. Probably not allowed to say that. But anyways, you know what I'm talking about. Then I started doing a little research on it. Electric motors are amazing. The torque immediately at 1 RPM is your full torque. Standard
gas motors
with the pistons up and down, hundreds of pieces. Electric motor spins, nothing ever goes wrong with it. They're amazing. So now all of a sudden I'm an electric motor guy, and rather than let her do her hot rod, I'm going to convert my hot rod to electric. So what I got is I got an old 36 Hayes over there. I don't know if you can see it, but and right now I have my flathead conversion kit in it, which is a small block Chevy made to look like a flathead. I'm going to yank that out, and I'm going to put my new patented electric, either electric flathead or electric small block Chevy. So what I got here, I'm just working on it now. These are the pieces. So what I do is I make pieces out of wood and Bondo. So essentially, if you look at that, any of you gearheads, you know that's a, just like this here, a head on a small block Chevy. Well, I need a hollowed out head. Hello. So, and this is the back part of the motor. I'm going to do it in a few different pieces. I'll just explain it now. So this is the back of the motor where you bolt to your transmission. Now, I don't know, a lot of you maybe don't know a lot about electric, but if you run a transmission, if you got a 4-speed transmission run behind an electric motor, you only need half the capacity of your motor because you got the gears. So, and I'm going lower voltage. I'm going 96 to 144 volts. It's a lot easier than Tesla 400, 800 volts or whatever. So this is going to be the back part of the motor. This is going to be the front part of the motor. Like, so normally on a small block Chevy, that's this part here. But of course I got a 9-inch electric motor I got to get in. So I made a removable piece that is going to bolt on the front. And then what I got here, you're going to go, boy, that's a long V8. Well, what it is, this is actually just done in two pieces. So it'll be the right side and the left side, or passenger or driver's side. And so that'll be these sides. So what my idea is, it's going to be a small block Chevy. It'll bolt in, but it's going to be electric. You can keep it looking like you got a Corvette. You can use your own valve covers, whatever you want. You can run fake spark plugs if you want. I'm gonna make mine a little bit semi-modern looking, you know? So essentially what's gonna happen is the electric motor is gonna sit inside here. And then for those of you who aren't familiar, an AC motor has these controllers. Controllers, I was gonna sit on the top of these big wires and everything coming out, but I decided to actually put it inside the motor itself. I'm gonna cool it with electric fan and also water cooling, and then my manifold will go on top like this. It'll have a air cleaner with a fan in it that'll blow air through over the controllers, and I also have a water pump that mounts on your small block Chevy that runs water cooling through your controllers. Right now I'm just using the tri-carb setup here. Speaking of carburetors, Emmy, come down here. Show them my 8 carburetors on my V16 MG. I know we're talking electric, but I just want to show you guys that, you know what? I'm a gas engine guy, but I'm being converted to electric. This is my V16 and my 56 MGA. 8 carburetors. I've had this car for 42 years. And then I'm going to take you over. Let's show them the Hayes, which is a 36 Hayes. It originally started out as a Mack truck. My grandfather had this, and the cab got wrecked, so we ended up putting a Hayes cab on it. This is the only 36 Hayes in the world. They were made in Vancouver, British Columbia, actually. And so what we're going to do is we're going to pull my flathead out, which is actually not a flathead. It's actually a small block Chevy. Pull that out, and we're going to go electric. Hey guys, this is my daughter Emmy. I was going to ask her a few questions about electric vehicles. Hey Emmy, what do you think of Nissan Leafs?
I like the idea of saving the environment.
Yeah.
I don't like the look of the Leaf or the Chevy Bolt. I do like the Teslas.
Teslas are cool. Yeah. Yeah. So why don't you do, what drive around a Tesla instead of a electric hot rod? Like, why do you want to go electric hot rod?
Well, I want to go hot rod in general, but as someone who doesn't know very much about engines or working on cars, my sister drives an old vintage van and it breaks down on her like every second day.
Yeah, she phones dad all the time. Every time I get the phone rings, it's like, oh no, Kelsey, what happened today? You know.
That's a stress that I don't need in my life. And yep. Electric cars are completely reliable and I know I'm doing my part in saving the world.
Right on. Sounds good. So what I'm thinking of doing is a blog or something. I don't know. My daughter said, hey, Dad, you're going to do this blog thing or whatever. So people interested in this can kind of follow me, see what I'm doing. Some of the interesting things is castings. So I'm going to cast this. Now, this is called a pattern. I used to always call it a mold. My casting guy's like, it's not a mold. It's a goddamn pattern. Anyway, so the pattern, we make this bigger because when you cast this, it actually shrinks. So this is made out of wooden Bondo, so I have to make it, every foot it shrinks a quarter inch, so I had to make it double size because I'm going to actually cast this out of aluminum. So I'm going to actually let you see the casting process and that, and then I'm going to weld these together. I'll show you the motor. I'm having a dual motor system. I'm going 96 volts, and the reason I'm going 96 volts rather than say 144 is the 96 volts, I can get about 250 foot-pounds of torque at 1 RPM. My truck weighs 6,000 pounds, but I want to burn the rubber off that thing. And if I go 144 volts, I got less torque up to 5,000 RPM. I'm only going to have my full torque at 3,000 RPM, but I got a 4-speed on it, so that should suffice, I think. And I do also have room to make a V12 if I need to put bigger engine, like a double 75 they call it, or whatever, if I need more torque. And down the road I wouldn't mind going 400, 500 horsepower, maybe 400 volts. One of the problems right now is battery costs. Batteries, for me to go down to the store and back or down to the coffee shop, you're talking 10 grand. Now, I'm talking Canadian. Down in the States, that'd be 50, 60 bucks maybe. But technology is there. Chevy Bolts, they've got their prices way down because they buy in such volume. So guys like you and I right now, we can't really get the deal on the batteries. We can use old Bolt batteries. We can buy new Bolt batteries. But once again, you're getting into the higher voltages and stuff. So I'm hoping I'm a year or two ahead, and when you guys actually decide you want to put one of these in your car, we're going to get you a deal on some batteries, and maybe you can do the batteries for about $5,000 or something. The other thing is the motors are expensive. These dual motor setups, AC, they're around 10 Canadian, 10 grand Canadian that is, right? So it's an expensive proposition, but you know, I think it's going to be worth it. And like I say, hopefully prices will come down as more and more people get on board. And you know, I talk to buddies of mine, or I go to a car show and I go, hey, I'm thinking of, you know, going electric. And they're all like, I'm expecting them to go, oh, what a weirdo or whatever. But they're all like, oh man, Chris, that's really cool. I'd love to do that. I always want it. But they don't know anything about electric motors, just like I did 2 months ago. And I'm learning. And I've got some good people who are helping me out. Up in Parksville, there's Can EV he's helping me out. He's bringing the motors in for me, and he's helping me with, he's going to show me how to wire it up and all that type of stuff. So, but I mean, I've done a lot of stuff in my life, and I do not fear the electricity, and you guys shouldn't either. As long as you can get the coin, right? If you got the money, we can give you an electric hot rod. So somehow or other, I'm going to do some type of a blog or a YouTube thing or whatever. And, you know, over 2 or 3 months, I'm actually going to Mexico for a month. So in January, so I may have to finish it off in February. But I'm hoping in 3 or 4 months, we should have this baby on the road. And I'm going to burn the bloody rubber right off the back of that thing. I might even put line locks on it. What do you think? Thank you.